Hello, good day. It's another interesting episode. Welcome. Stay tuned with me for the entire episodes. Today I'm going to share with you a very interesting highway. It's been regarded as the most beautiful highway in the world, or some people like to call it the heavenly highway. It is the Karakoram Highway. Karakoram Highway is actually a recently completed highway and has achieved some world famous renown in terms of engineering as well in terms of landscape and scenery. Let's move on with today's episode on this fascinating and breathtaking landscape of the Karakoram Highway. So today I'm going to cover three areas. One is actually the Gage River Gorge. And then the next section we're going to cover a highland lake we call it White Sand Lakes. And then thirdly we have another place called Karakul Lakes. These are all a fascinating place to visit as far as concerned in terms of scenery. It's perfect for landscape photographer. You will like this place if you were to like landscape. Okay, a quick one go through the Xinjiang. The Xinjiang actually is the one of the northwesternmost province and also the largest province of China, which is taken up about 1/6 of the landmass of China. And of course, the section that we are covering is considered the southern Xinjiang, the area colored blue. And this zoning of northern and southern Xinjiang are by virtue a mountain range, the cutting them into two, that is the Tian Shan mountain range. And as you notice from this map, you can see that the Tian Shan mountain range is right in the middle, and we are now covering the part that actually nearest to the westernmost of this southern Xinjiang. And then look at the map of this is actually the Karakoram Highway. And let me give you some breakdown of this Karakoram Highway before you go into the scenery part. Now, Karakoram Highway is an international road linking two nations, and basically the Pakistan and China. Thus, it's known as a China-Pakistan Friendship Highway. Internationally, this stretch of highway was named N-35 or N-35 or called National Highway 35. For the Chinese, in the China portion, is known as the G314 highway, as quoted by the China government. Now, this highway is not only been regarded as one of the most beautiful highway in the world due to presence of many scenic spots along the route, but also regarded as the 8 wonders of the world. Now, it's also one of the highest paved roads in the world, having passing through three mountain ranges, namely the Himalaya, the Karakoram, and Hindu Kash mountain ranges. Many travelers name this highway as the heavenly route on earth due to its spectacular landscape along the entire stretch of the highway. Now, you look at the map itself, you can see that this highway, the starting point is from Kashgar. And the ending point, or Kashgar, we also known as Kashi, just for some of you informations, in China, and then it ended and Abbottabad in Pakistan as the southernmost of this highway, with a total length of about 1,300 kilometers, with 805 kilometers length on the Pakistan section and remaining in the China section. And today I'm going to bring you to the China section, of course not the full sections. We only cover approximately about maybe 300 to close to 400 kilometers of distance, right, from Kashgar all the way down to a town nearby, the last town in this Karakoram Highway in the China section. Now, the constructions of this highway were funded by both government, that means the China and Pakistan governments, and was completed in 1979. And only opened the traffic and public in the year 1989. 85, that means about 35 years from now. Now, 35 years have passed, this highway still constantly undergo expansion and upgrading with the aim of ensuring better safety and durability against the harsh climates and the geographical condition imposed upon them. And even during our visit itself, we found that there is still doing along the stretch, we're still having a lot of constructions, and mainly these constructions are actually construction of underground drainage channels below the roads to ensure that during the rainy season, the flood water will not flood over the roads, but it just discharged underground. Because if we look at the topography, that this highway is running along the mountain ranges on one side, so a high on one end and low on the other end. They mean on if you're driving, you're going towards south, right? If you're driving towards south, Pakistan, you'll realize actually the ranges, mountain ranges, are mostly on your right hand side, and then on the left hand side of the road is actually is the gorge or the valley. So water running from the right to the left, right? Now, so let's move on with some of scenery. And first of all, the first stretch of the scenery that we're going to cover is called the River, the Gage River Gorge. Now, let me share you some of the fact about this place. Now, this Gage River Gorge, or they call them Otter Canyons. Some people like to call it because it's actually is also around this canyon area. Now, this Otter Canyon, also known as the Gage River Gorge, as the Gage River runs through the canyon with two mountain ranges running parallelly to the highway with the Gage River side by side. Right? The main that is two mountain range and the route itself and the Gage River are all running almost parallelly. So basically, the Karakul Range is on the northwestern direction and the Kongo Range on the southeastern directions, just for your info, right? Now, this stretch of highway is popular as known as Gage River Gorge. It's quite long and it's a stretch about 82 kilometers. And from the images I'm going to share with you, is the images taken along the 82 km stretch of this Karakoram Highway. And which an altitude ranging from about 1,570 meter till 3,300 meter. They mean you are traveling from 1,500 to 3,000 altitude range. And just before we reach the White Sand Lakes, then the gorge suddenly widens, and then you will see there's again another beautiful scenery. There's actually the White Sand Lakes. But let's cover this portion of the highway first. As we cover the highway itself, of course, I'm going to share with you also some of the interesting facts that we can come across on this highway. Let's move on. So you can see that on the picture, you can see basically it's a beautiful gorge and valley, and you can see some running waters. It's a river, the Gage River is running parallel with the highway. And you can see, even though so we are, certain stretch of the highway look very remote and very deserted, so there's no tree whatsoever. But actually is to give you a very stunning view. This world-renowned highway, for most users of the highway, is an epic road trip full of unforgettable memory and a breathtaking journey as well. Over the entire stretch of the highway, one is expected to meet many ethnic and religious groups of people, particularly in the Pakistan sections. Indeed, a road trip but not to be missed in a lifetime. Now, along this gauge highway, that you're passing through many scenic spots. And of course, first of all, the Gage River Canyon, we mentioned just now, The next one is White Sand Lakes, then followed by Karakul Lakes. Along the way, also be able to see few of the highest mountain range in these regions, namely the Mutaata, which actually in the altitude 7,546 meter, Kongo Tas, which also the next highest highway mountains at 7,649 meter, and Kongo Tuber, which actually 7,530 meter at close distance. Alright, so let's see some of the. This is actually the highway engineering works. The bridges actually certain stretch of the highway itself is actually run above a constructed concrete pathway, or you call it the bridges. And then thereafter, the end of the bridges is actually the tunnels. And you can see that there's still a lot of reconstruction and upgrading works are in progress. You can see from this picture, and you can see at right 5 far of these images, you can see the snow-capped mountain range between view. So during the dry season, of course, you will not have much water on these rivers. But you can see the on this image, you can see the how high is this highway was constructed on this suspended bridge, or rather said, you can see the bridge or the roots on the your so-called the leftmost side of your hand. You can see that how high is it away down from this valley. And this is the mountain range that you view along the way. Most of these images are taken on the moving bus. Unfortunately, we can't really stop here and there along the highway, because I think you're going to obstruct the traffic. So we can best is that to try our luck to take these pictures while the bus is still on the moving toward the direction, the destination we want to go. It was actually quite a cloudy day, you can see from the images. And the topography, the soil, the earth colors change from section to section. Certain portion you have a lot of red earth, red mountains. Certain part you find that actually the colors of the reddish mountain disappear. You can see from this is the gorge, the Gatch River Gorge, that the road is running parallel to it. And this is another view before we enter these tunnels. And in this section, there is basically the red color earth, or already brownish red color earth appear. You can find many such bridges or so-called roads built on in these natures along the way. So this is just some of the view as you travel past this Gatch River Gorge, which actually stretches about 82 kilometers. And at this point, there's a spot for us to stop by, and therefore we get down and took a bit more pictures. It's almost treeless in this zone, and the altitude at this point is easily above 2,000 meter above sea level. You can see some of the frost that left behind, or snow that by yesterday night. You know, they mean they can see that this altitude, how high is it, and also the temperature at night at this area. Is definitely is near to frozen zero temperatures. It is one of the valley or gorge around the area. Very rocky and very rough. what is a natural landscapes created by the god. And the scenery, as it start moving on, the scenery start to change again. The earth, the topography, the soils, all start changing. And in here, that you see that the gorge is start to widening, and the mountain range, the snow-capped mountain range, are much closer to us now. And we are actually approaching of altitude is closing to 3,000 meter when you are reaching at this point. The higher point of this highway is near the Kunjarab Pass, which actually is the pass that going to Pakistan, as an altitude of 4,714 meter. Of course, in our trip, we do not go to that point, right? And there are many checkpoints along this highway, and therefore the security are very, very tight, and not anybody can come here. When you want to visit here, actually you need to get a permit. That's something I will advise you, that the backpacking is strongly not recommended and it's not advisable, because if you are without touring in the groups under the tour agency of the China tour agency organize this trip, I think the chances that you will detained and asked to go back, because they seldom issue permit for foreigner to travel on a backpack or free and easy basis in here, or self-drive. So you can see that now we have a much wider view of as we move on towards the White Sand Lakes regions. Yes, you can see that at this hour, actually we leave and we start to travel fairly early, because also this high altitude, so the temperature here are fairly cold in the morning. A beautiful scene, you know. We did stop at this point and take some pictures. This is one of the images I like best. You can see the morning mist. And the highway, this is what you can see, that the highway was well maintained. Of course, at this stretch, the upgrading work was done very recently. And in fact, in certain stretch, actually the highway was completely under the reconstruction condition, and therefore we asked to detour, you know, zigzag moving to avoid the construction sites along the highway where the underground drainage is under construction. So finally, we are going to go get close to the White Sand Lakes, and then see that the horizon is much wider and also much closer to all those mountain peaks, those are higher mountain peaks. And you can see that the peak that you have seen in this picture are one of the three mountain I have just mentioned, and is all above 7,500 meter above sea level, the height of the mountain, the peak. So So full of mountain ranges, snow-capped mountain ranges along the way, particularly at the last portion of this Gatch River Gorge before we come to the White Sand Lakes regions. Well, this is a closer view because as I say, this mountain range, as I say just now, is running parallel with the Karakoram Highway. We are lucky that during this day when we travel, we have a good weather, sunny weather. So the wonderful scenic spot, if you like this type of landscapes. Because we are running parallel, so literally speaking that all these mountain range are all 5,000 meter above sea level, most of it. So they can see most of them are snow-capped. As the general guide itself, the most mountains were snow-capped 1 year above 4,000 meter above sea level, particularly at the toward the northern higher of the northern part, like for example in Xinjiang, in this area, in this zone. Then finally, we landed ourselves to a very wide when the gorge has widened. To a very wide valley, or rather a basin, or a grass. It's not even grassland, there's no grass at all. And there is where the White Sand Lake is located. So let me share with you some info about the White Sand Lakes. Now, White Sand Lake actually is an artificial lake formed after the completion of an highland reservoir on the Bulungkau River. The lake got its name because the white sand dunes surround the lakes. It is located at the end of a Gatch River Gorge when the gorge is suddenly widened. Near to it live the Kashgar people, another minority ethnic group of China. So let's see some of this White Sand Lakes scenery. Here is the lakes. You can see the sand dune. Now, why traveling in China, particularly at this part of China? You have to remember that the government really imposed quite a lot of restrictions. And therefore, while going through this scenery, I would like to highlight a few things that you must make sure you have before you travel to this part of the world. You need a travel permit, which can only be obtained in Kashgar City, and need to apply generally 3 days in advance, but most of the time you need to apply through a travel agency. Now next thing is a very limited hotel in this region will allow foreign visitor or guests, because in China the hotels, they are classified open to foreigner and not opening to foreigner. So in this area, the number of hotels that is allowed to open to entertain foreigner guests is very limited. And therefore, backpacking style traveling is not possible as a permit only to foreigner world tour agency. So this is something I would like to highlight while we're going through some of these beautiful images of White Sand Lakes. So this is exactly where the lake are located, and I managed to walk close to the shore or edge of the lakes and to capture some images. This is actually right at the shoreline. And the mountain range is just next to it. So at this point, actually, it is really more than 3,000 meters above sea level. So more of a scenery view. Sorry, I pressed a bit too fast. Let's go back. Sorry, just now accidentally. Very, very beautiful. I hope I could stay longer. But of course, we are also on a hurry going down to another Tashkurgan, the last city of this Karakoram Highway before we U-turn back. Because from the Karakoram Highway all the way to Tashkurgan, the further down actually is actually the border to Pakistan, which is not in form part of our travel itinerary. Well, this is all the scenery that you can see along these white sand lakes. See the sand dune, although it doesn't look white, but of course people like to use this name as a white sand lakes. Then we move on. And the next important spot where we are going to visit is actually in our highland lakes. We call them Karakul lakes. And it's actually after White Sand Lake, then we travel further up on southwards. Then as you're going southward, actually you are traveling is what you call them on the plateau called Pamir Plateau. So in other words, actually all this area when we are traveling along the Karakul Highway, actually is on the Pamir Plateaus. It's for your info. So this highland lake surrounded by a grassland, this Karakul Highway, Karakul Lakes, right? It's located along the Karakoram Highway. It's about 169 kilometers south of Kashgar City. They mean we are now away from Kashgar City, close to 2,000 kilometers away. It's about 3,600 meters now above sea level. Now, it's a very popular stopover this, as far as this lake is concerned. And for most travelers, traveling on these routes, alright, with very beautiful scenic view of two of the highest mountain peaks, there's a Mutata and also Konguta. Both of them are actually 7,005 and 7,006 meters, the highest and the second highest mountain can be viewed from this lake area. Now these two mountain peaks are all year round snow capped, just for your info. The glaciers from these two mountains can also be easily seen from this location during a good weather, and in fact we are lucky we are able to see some of these glaciers. Here you can find many eatery and souvenir store or shops, right, and a large parking area. So this basically is one of the best stopover because it's almost in the midpoint between the Kashgar and the pass before enter to Pakistan, about at the midpoint area. It's also almost the highest point of as far as this road, but not I refer to this the pass. The pass, of course, as I mentioned here, the pass to the Pakistan is 4,000 meter above sea level. Now the summit point, okay, let's move on with that, and then we'll share with you more info about this highway and this stretch. You can see that this is actually the surrounding scene while traveling, and actually the lorry, the bus that's traveling, it actually is the roads that we are driving, and that is actually the Karakoram Highway. And this vehicle will just stop by at one in the corner point and to take the beautiful scenery around these regions. Now, actually at this point, actually we are most close to the summit point of the roads. As far as not, as I said, keep excluding the pass that before I enter to Pakistan. It's already 4,020 meters above sea level. You see the mountains? The peaks is one of the one I have just mentioned just now. Can you see the glacier? Unfortunately, the peak at this moment was covered by cloud. This is a much closer view of the glacier. And we see that there are two of them. All these are captured during on the moving bus. Unfortunately, we don't stop, and also because it's there's no place for the car, the bus or the car to stop by. Much closer view of the glacier. It's a more treeless in these regions. So far, again, from all the images I showed so far until now, we're not able to spot any vegetation, trees of that sort. Look at the vehicle, the size of the vehicle compared to the mountain backdrops. You can see how huge and how magnificent the view is at this point. The glacier is just right in front of your view. So finally, we are closing to this Karakoram Highway at this stretch where this is the Karakul Lakes in these regions, and you see that you sort of have see the some of the stream. Actually, is part this stream are the water are flowing to the lakes, and actually during the wet season during the summer, this area is the grassland. And this is actually the lake, the Karakul Lakes, which is 3,600 meters above sea level. And you can see the mountain range right at the back. It's actually the Mustaata mountain range with 7,509 meters above sea level. This is a foreground. You can see that the shallow part of the lakes. So you can see the range, mountain range, that run parallels, and all of them are snow caps. So we managed to cover these lakes both on the way and on the return journey. So actually we are taking these images from a few directions, few angles on the left side of the lake and then on the right side of the lake on the return journey. So you can see that the scenery of the images that taken earlier and now, there are slight differences because of time, you know, and different time of the day. And you can see that here actually is more toward the noon time, and the sun is directly shining on it. You can see the shadow imposed by the cloud above. Point to note that they actually before I mentioned just now the point to mention to you, this is actually at the summit point. In fact, the Chinese government are strongly promoting tourism to these regions, and you can see there's one of the entrance gates was constructed to provide a viewing platform to view the highest mountain peaks. In fact, this is almost at the summit point of this highway, and it's still under construction. So I believe that the when it's completed, it will enter to the viewing platform to take picture of this mountain range and also the mountain peaks, highest peaks of this highway. You have not definitely had to pay your entrance fees. So that is going to come by very soon when this tourist spot, so-called the specially selected tourist spot, is completed constructions. So you can see that actually currently it's been barricaded, you know. So why we are going through all these travels, and I would like to also mention that the highland sickness thing. Please take note that because we are traveling from 1,001 meter all the way ascended to close to 4,000 meter, and there's actually a quick ascent of close to 2,500 meters. For some of you may not be able to take it, they may have suffered the symptom of highland sickness. So get yourself prepared if you are coming to this place, because happened in our tour groups, there one of our tour mates had to return back to Kashgar because they cannot take the high altitudes, which even at the point when our tour mate suffering is it's only about 3,500 meter above sea level. It's only at that altitude. So remember that you are expected to reach a peak of 4,220 meter above sea level. A good thing is that we are not overnight, because the highland sickness will more severe when actually if you stay overnight. Because during the night when you sleep, your metabolism rate are slowed down, and that's where the highland sickness will hit you badly compared to during a daytime. If you just pass over a pass, even though it's 4,000 meters above sea level, but your staying time, if it's just an hour or so, normally the highland sickness will not affect you at all, because it's just a very short stay at the high altitude. So this is something to share for friends who are eager to come over. And please slow down your activity. Everything you have to slow it down when you come to this altitude. So you can see this is the end of my introduction of this Karakoram Highway, the southern stretch, the northern stretch of Karakoram Highway in the China sections. Just a bit intro what I'm going to share with you in the next episode. Actually, is another very interesting place called Tian Shan Grand Canyon, and it can seen from these images. So this is the end of today's episode. I hope you enjoy. Have a nice tour of this Karakoram Highway, the heavenly roads of the world. And I hope that you will stay tuned again with me for our next episode that will come in the next Saturday. And remember, stay strong, stay safe, and stay at home. Many best wishes to all my photographer friends, my travel mates, and friends around the world. Bye. See you soon in the next episode.